You've waited a lifetime to look better and feel better, and now here's your chance. Fitness Friday on WNDB. Call 239-0033 and have your questions answered on health, fitness, and a better life. Fitness Friday is brought to you by Bodies by Tasso & Company, 1140 West Granada Boulevard in Ormond Beach. And now, here's your host, Tasso Kyriakis.
You know, it's like some things just never change. It's like you got new stuff in the studio here, and this one mic still has the droopy mic.
The droopy mic.
Well, welcome to Fitness Friday. It's a day that the first thing I want to really talk about, because I really want to get this out there. You know, I think that when you have your health, when you have your happiness, and when you have your family, those probably are three very big concerns that all of us have every day. And everything we talk about on this radio show is about trying to bring your health and happiness and prosperity to you, because you are involved in a program that is moving you in the right direction. And in the month of October, we're trying something we've never tried before. I think it's going to be a rather unique promotion that we do. But we're going to make it this whole period of time. You know, we're starting to go into the holiday season, and want to make it that holiday time where family is so important. So, you know, like the family that exercises together, stays together, the family that eats together, builds better relationships together. Mm-hmm. So we're going to have it be family fitness. And what we're going to do, when you sign up at Bodies Personalized Fitness for $199 enrollment fee, that's our normal single member enrollment fee, and the monthly dues of $59.50, you're going to receive a family membership. Now, a family membership will be husband, wife, or significant other, you and your significant other, and your offspring that live with you in your house. And that's going to give you that membership at that price until the beginning of the year. Now, that solves some problems that people have sometimes. You know, they wonder if their children are going to stick with the program. They wonder if their spouse is going to stick with the program. This gives you the opportunity, when you know that you want to exercise, to come enroll in a membership and get a family membership for the single membership price. I think it's a neat thing. We'll see how it works out. I think it's a great offer. But, you know, it doesn't matter what I think. It matters what people think out there. But it's a great opportunity to get your family exercising together. And, of course, being hopefully the good business people we are, we will also offer some great incentives to keep your family on. But imagine that, 3 months of a family membership, no enrollment fees for them. There will be a little card fee. It's $20 for a card. But there'll be a card fee is all they'll have to pay, and they're off and running with you at the single membership rate for you. So that I hope people will take advantage of that. They can call 672-6464. So now let's get caught up on some current event things. Number one is I'd like to thank Mitch from Love Whole Foods for the time he spent as a co-sponsor of the show. Mitch is now putting up a big billboard that will replace his time investment that with us. What? Yeah, billboards are good deals, but I really appreciate Mitch's insight and that he's brought to the show. And he's going to take a little sabbatical from us doing the co-hosting deal. It'll be back to just me, boring old me, people have to listen to. And then, but I really appreciate that. Dr. Fon will continue to be one of our sponsors. And, you know, Dr. Fon has been a great help to me during this Dancing with the Stars things I've been to. Daytona Dancing with the Stars.
You ought to have a donut shop as a co-sponsor.
Work that out.
We could. I don't know how that's going to work out. You know, how do you bring Jim Anderson? How do you bring Jim Anderson, Krispy Kreme? So Jim, let's talk about the health benefits of donuts. But you know, we've always taught on this show moderation. Number one, we've always taught that. Listen, we don't want to be in a state of deprivation. Now, we also don't want to be in a state of gluttony. But going back to Dr. Fon, he's been a great help to me, because as I've expanded what I've done in preparation for the Dancing with the Stars promotion and charity event, what has happened is I've tended to really get some wear and tear on a knee that I have that has a history. And so I've been going to Dr. Fon, and I've been working with him. He's been doing a great job helping me out with it. I really appreciate it. And it reiterates the situation that when you have a traumatic event that is an injury, that he can have a great benefit to you from that standpoint. Also, he works from a standpoint of chronic things that take a little longer to work with. So we work from that standpoint of we have a great relationship with it. So being that I've gotten off talking to Dancing with the Stars, the guy who is responsible for me being on Dancing with the Stars is in the studio, Terry Savaston. And Terry, you know, this whole thing happened because of you, because your little mouth. And somehow I'm going to get even with you. It started. There was a little measure of revenge this Monday at Quarterback Club when they announced the guy who had the least number of picks right, and they went Terry Savage, and I went, Terry, really? That's so great. And I told my whole table why I'm dancing with the stars, and it's your fault, and that. Now I got to tell you, it's been a very pleasurable experience dancing with the stars.
See, look, you know, no good deed goes unpunished. But, you said so yourself.
I think Eva flashed her eyes at you or something. You know, right?
I did say I thought I was going to get the dance with Eva, and that was sort of part of the motivation. Then my dance instructor looked at me, and go, really? I'm right here. You know, I said nothing personal. I said, but she's, you know, I'm more attracted to brunettes than I am to blondes. You know, but my dance.
And he blames me. Remember that. Said, Dave. My fault.
My dance instructor is a very patient person, believe me.
She should have to be.
Oh, yeah. She's brought me along, and it's coming along. I'm not saying I'm going to win the crystal ball, because that's like Fred Flintstone, like winning something. I don't know, man. It's like it's going to be something. It'll be an experience. But I'm just telling you that what the charity should do is they should, at the 4-week mark, they should give you a buyout that you can get out of the competition. Because all the extra money I've spent on all the things I'm doing to get ready for this, if I'd have just donated that money to the charity, they would have been tons ahead. So, you know, but it's I'm enjoying it. It's been a nice release to be able to go down there. I've been really good on my diet so that I sort of look good. I don't want to look like, I keep teasing her. I said, I don't want to look like Shrek dancing with Princess Fiona. You know, it's like she's this little skinny blonde hair going, you know, I'm going to be like, you know, the Hulk. It's like, So I'm trying to lean out so I look like, you know, a decent human being and not some Neanderthal.
What are you going to wear?
I don't know yet. She's thinking about a waiter outfit for me of some sort, because our dance tells a little bit of a story. Okay. So it's going to be real interesting. I'm sort of interested to see how it all turns out, to be quite honest.
What are you doing? A tango? No, you're doing a
rumba.
A rumba.
A rumba. And a rumba is the vertical expression of your horizontal desires or something like that. So that's what she told me about it. I'm going like, really? I said, I don't really need to know that. So I'm trying to work on it. So I hope people, and you can now go to dbss.org. That's Daytona Beach Symphony Society.org, dbss.org. And you can go there and see who all the Dancing in the Stars are. And I hope that you will go click on Tasso, and you will then become sponsor somehow, either a $10 sponsorship
or a table
or just a ticket. You know what we're doing at the club is we have Zumba at the club on Wednesday evenings, and we're actually going to add Monday and Saturday evenings. Monday evenings and Saturday mornings. Those times will be announced, and when they start will be announced. But we charge $5 for members.
Are you teaching Zumba?
No, I'm not teaching Zumba. did not say I was teaching Zumba. I said we have Zumba at the club. And by having the Zumba, what we do is when you pay your $5 or $10, you get to go to the class. $10 for non-members, $5 for members. But what we're doing with that money is we're compiling it. Let's say we make $750 profit. All the profit after paying the instructors is going to go to the event. And this is how, we're not just going to donate the money to the event. What we're going to do is we're going to say, all right, we have $750. We're going to buy a table of 10. And everybody who went to the Zumba classes, we're going to pull their names out of a hat and get 10 people that want to go to the event itself. So I think it's a nice way of saying to people, look, we're very thankful that you're coming. We want you to help sponsor. And so it's sort of neat from that standpoint. So we're doing that now, and it's sort of neat. And I think it's consistent to it. And I actually think our family promotion is consistent to the situation as well, to be honest with you, Terry. I think it's consistent from the standpoint of what we're doing with families working out together. And again, if you did not hear, we began October 1st with a very special promotion that if you join a single membership at regular rate, what you will receive is a family membership for you, your significant other, spouse, and your children that you have living in the household with you. And you'll get that membership all the way till January 1st. You know, I don't want to go back and be disrespectful to my existing members by offering a discounted rate. So we've offered it for a short term, and of course we'll offer some incentives to keep your kids and your spouse on your membership. But it's going to be a neat little thing, I think, because and by the way, that will be our supervised body coach membership, our most popular membership. It's the one where you get the Body by Science program, you get the SciFit program, all that is what you get. So that's what we're going to be doing with that. So, you know, I still have not forgiven you because every 3 days a week I'm driving to Bunnell to go take dance lessons and to get ready for this. And then as soon as my Pilates and yoga and ballet instructor, yes, ballet instructor, get back in town, I will resume my schedule of ballet. And I've had to increase my visits to Dr. Fond to keep my knee from swelling on me.
But the result of this is maybe, just maybe, if you raise enough money, we'll get the London Symphony Orchestra back here, Tasso.
Well, you know,
so that's a plan.
Well, that's what, you know, one of the motivations for me is quite frankly is really wasn't that Eva was so attractive or any of the other women were so attractive that were calling and coming by to see me about it. It's that, you know, and I never would have seen this relationship develop when Mark Davidson came to me one day and when the Davidson still owned the News Journal and said to me, Tasso, he says, this is really doing me a lot of good. I want to get my father over here. And my first instincts was, wow, Tippin Davis is a big deal, you know. And then I said, well, wow, Tippin Davis is pretty liberal and very, you know, very staunch Democrat. And I think in my, from the standpoint of a lot of social issues, I'm very liberal and very democratic. But when it comes to all the other stuff, I think I'm very conservative. So I'm sitting there and sort of going like, oh my God, how in the world am I ever gonna deal with Tippin Davidson? If he really is this politically liberal guy and he's got all these views on, and I just really didn't know how I was going to deal with it. And I met him, and he was one of the most charming men I've ever met in my life. I loved Tippin Davidson, and he was one of the best friends that I ever had the pleasure of having. And I think he did so much for this community. And let's face it, there's so much that is of the arts in this community that would not be here if not for the aid of what Tippin. In fact, his passion for it is what got him in trouble with his business partners. But, you know, I think about Tippin all the time. Every time I'm driving in one of my dance lessons, I think I'm going like, all right, Tippin, you probably are laughing when you see me doing this. And I'm sure there's going to be a lot of people that are going to laugh that night, because there's going to be a lot of people that go like, wow, he really did it. You know, he really did it. How did he do that? So it'll be an interesting scenario for us, and we'll see. So
support Tasso in his dancing.
I would appreciate it, because let's face it, the only shot I got at this and the only thing that's going to save my ego is to win that trophy for most money being raised, and then you can go to DBSS and buy a ticket in my name, buy a table in my name, or just make a donation in my name, and I'd really appreciate it. Mm-hmm. Or come to Zumba, dance in the Zumba classes. Anything you do would be greatly appreciated. And so I know my daughters are looking forward to it. I got some special moves that I asked the dance instructor to help me put in. They're little things I used to do with my daughters when they were growing up. Yeah, they're not very rumba-ish, but they're sort of like little cute things. That like
professional judges, though? I mean, these people are professionals, and they'll be judging you on,
you know, I really don't know who the judges are. All I know at this point, ironically, the only judge I know for sure that is a judge is Debbie Kruk.
Bodybuilder.
She was Miss Fitness USA, and she runs a Pilates studio. That's actually the only person I know confirmed as an actual, as a judge. I don't know who the other judges are. I know they've been announced, but I really haven't looked at that part. I figured, listen, even paying the judges off isn't going to help me. Now, that being said, that might be a smarter way for me to go. But then they would be up for all that scrutiny, and there's no guarantee. So,
right.
You know, and I'm sure there's a lot of people who could pay a lot more money than me for to have the votes. So,
Tasso, you're welcome.
Yeah, thanks a lot. someday, man, it's going to happen. When you least expect it. So Terry, you're doing a football game tonight. It's not what we'd say is a thriller and chiller that we're gonna have at the stadium tonight.
We got Maidland and Deltona tonight.
Yeah. And historically, that has not been a great game.
No, it's tough. You know, they're part of the district. It's an important game because this is a district game. But we got to give, you know, you've got some programs there on the west side of the county that are just building, and it's going to take some time, and they're coming along. Yeah. But they need to play teams like this to get some experience, and I think it'll be, it's good for both teams to get out there and see what each other has, and it'll be interesting. We'll be keeping an eye on some other games going on. I think Warner and Atlantic's playing tonight.
I think that's going to probably be the marquee game of the night here.
And who knows? You might even see me swing in and catch the end of that game if ours is over early enough. I might stop by the Warner game and just see what the score is. on my way home. So looking forward to tonight's game. Not sure about next week. Working on next week's game. We'll keep you posted there. But if there are some other games going on around the county, Taylor's out at Calvary Christian. DeLand University, another district game. That's important. P.K. Young's across the street at Father Lopez. That's another district game. Pine Ridge at New Smyrna, that's another district game. So district play's starting to kick up. Matanzas at Creekside, another district game. Flagler Palm Coast at Ocala Westport, that's another district game. So there's some district games going on. Seabreeze taking the week off this week, and so
they got a big game next week. I'll tell you they're going down to Cocoa, and so that's going to be a big game. I think that's an important one for them because, you know, they look pretty decent. And you know, sometimes you gain by subtraction. You know, everybody was so worried about Seabreeze losing Trayvon Rodriguez to go to Mainland, and a couple other kids that left to go, I think one to Atlantic and one to Mainland. And good kids, and they left, unfortunately. But I think that it shows a great coaching job and great team unity. They've been able to pull that together.
It creates opportunities, yeah. You know, and that's what football, I think high school football is about, is the opportunity to learn and grow, and that's what's so cool about it. I get to see we're there every game, and we're there every year, and we get to see the young kids that are standing on the sidelines this year that'll be playing next year, yeah. And who knows, some of them have been in the game already. We've seen some young kids, and I'm sure Mainland's going to see some of those kids tonight get out there and play against Deltona, yeah. And get, yeah, that opportunity too. So we'll get to mention some new names tonight, and you know, who knows, next year that could be the star of the team.
Well, it's like Jack Youngblood said the other day, is he had the opportunity because of an injury, that he got the opportunity to play pro football the way he got to play it, and got mentored by the people he got to be mentored by. And that's just the way it goes. You have to be prepared to step up in life to experience and take the opportunity to experience things. And then, you know, an interesting thing, you know, and you don't know what those kids are going to become. This week on Facebook, my daughter directed me to read an article by a young man named Perry Kostadakis. His mom is fighting breast cancer. And Perry is now one of the main editors at the FSU newspaper.
Cool.
For sports and that. It's a great article, and, you know, my hat's off to Perry for writing such a beautiful article and showing how kids love their family, love their moms and dads and stuff. It was just a really sweet thing for him to do. I got to get on Facebook and just comment back to him. I'm so proud of him for that. But there's a kid that was on the sidelines at Seabreeze, talked about that a little bit in his little article, and now he's not playing football at the next level, but look at what he's doing. He's gonna be a great journalist.
That being on the sidelines, being involved with football, it gives you the perspective of what get involved, whether it be on the field, off the field. You know, I only played in my high school career one play.
Right.
Okay, one play in my high school career. I'm still involved with football because, yeah, of that. And you know, that one play wasn't why I'm doing it. I'm doing it because I spent a lot of time on the sidelines, not just as a player, but I became manager and went on to Appalachian State as manager, right, and got involved with some great coaches that just, yeah, inspired me to stay involved and help kids and get involved with it. I get excited. I don't know if you can tell, but I really get excited about football, Tasso.
Well, I think all of us do. We enjoy it, and it's neat to live vicariously through the kids we meet, the kids we train, and things like that over the years. So it's a great service, and I appreciate that WNDB has brought back that tradition several years ago of having high school football on the radio, and people can listen in. And, you know, always go out and take those games and enjoy them because it's something to
take
do.
Your radio with you when you go to the game, even if you're not at our game, so you can keep,
yeah,
up,
keep
with
up
what's
with the
going
scores.
On.
There you
know?
Go.
And we try to keep up with all the games and get the scores out there during the game. So.
All right. Well, let's talk a little bit about fitness and talk a little bit about what's going on from the standpoint of fitness. You know, more and more I'm seeing more and more articles come up that are coming into the paper that really seem to reflect this shift, quite frankly, that we've been talking about for some time in the recognition of what goes on in our health. And, you know, when we look at this, Dr. Daniel Pompa, who's been a guest on this show several times, I will be heading – actually won't be at the Greek Festival this year, Dave. I'm going to be in Las Vegas. Yes.
Really?
I'm going to be in Las Vegas. So 3 days before we have the Dancing with the Stars,
MetXi will go out of business.
They will. MetXi might be in trouble. I think they'll still drink
they're
enough.
They're counting on you to make their year.
I think they're going to drink enough. I just think it'll be less than what they normally drink. And you know, the director of the festival, Irene, will get her wish. She always wanted a quiet, the more docile Heedle Booth that'll be there this year, I think. Mm. So, but here's the thing: is that we've spoken so much about this, and back to what I'm going back to this holistic medical practice education that's going on out in Las Vegas. Mm. I skipped it last year, but I'm at a point in my education where I absolutely need to be there for this one to go on to the other four segments that I need to have. So, but in this, he talks about what he calls the 5 R's of healing. And you know, I see these 5 R's becoming more and more prevalent as we start to see what's in the research and we start to see what's going on. And they what they apply to is they start to apply, and we don't think of healing. We don't think of weight loss as healing. But the core of what needs to happen for weight loss to occur and to get over weight loss resistance is really a healing process. So I wanted to talk a little bit about, I want to remind people a little bit of how the system works. You know, we have this system, and we have the pancreas, and it produces these two major enzymes, hormones, insulin and glucagon, okay? And what they do is, insulin is a storage enzyme for the sugar that's in your blood system. Glucagon releases the sugar from the cell so we can use it for an energy source, okay? Well, Americans on average, they consume 100, this is average now, 170 pounds of sugar per year, okay?
Really?
Really. That's average. That's not the kids who are doing nothing but sitting in front of the TV and eating the sugar things. And I got to tell you, I think the effect is even worse when we go to the diet things. Because you know what I've learned through this naturalistic approach that I've been studying from the nutrition aspect? I've learned a couple things. Number one I learned is that, you know, people who use diet drinks don't understand that those are neuroexcitotoxins. Mm-hmm. And we haven't talked much because it's sort of a complicated thing to talk about the NODD system. But this is a system that controls our ability to turn off these superoxides that come. We hear so much about free radicals,
right?
But these super free radicals that occur as a result of different eating and stress that's in our life. And so we have a balance that's supposed to be there. We have a balance that we're supposed to produce insulin and glucagon from the from the liver and the pancreas. So what happens is when we start to have too much sugar in our system, we get insulin dependent. We get insulin dominant. And what that does is take the cell membrane and make the cell so it can't really communicate to all the other hormones that need to be communicated with to run our body. Mm-hmm. The things from the hypothalamus to the pituitary to the adrenal, all those things are now in a poor communication pool.
Right.
And what that does is it slows our body. So now we see women who complain about menopause, who complain about the PMS, those things become more exasperated. And let's think back to cancer for just a moment. What is cancer? And it's really base, very simplistic. It doesn't matter what cancer it is. What it is this, is when we have cancer, it's the result of one of two things. What happened is that cell could no longer communicate, so it could get rid of toxins, so it could bring in nutrients, so it could carry on the daily culture and lifestyle of that cell, whatever that culture was. So what happens is the cell has two choices to make. It can either mutate, which is cancer, or it can die because it is now is not getting nourished, not getting rid of toxins. And what would happen? You would die. You would not become productive. Mm-hmm. So now Dr. Papa has put together what he calls his 5 R's of healing. Okay, and again, just before
we have half an hour to get in the 5 R's.
We got a half hour to get 5 R's. We'll get them in. Okay, so now when we look back to sugar being in our system and this balance between glucagon, which is our sugar burning, and insulin, which is our sugar storing enzymes, our hormones, what happens is when we can keep this balance, we also create a balance of other hormones, particularly ghrelin and leptin. Now, leptin is what turns on and off your hunger senses.
Really?
Okay? And tells us, hey, listen, you're done eating. You need to eat, that type of thing.
Okay.
And both leptin and ghrelin are very, very involved in the health of brain cells.
Hmm.
So now we begin to tie these high insulin levels. Now we see why diabetes is tied into increased rates of dementia and Alzheimer's.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the effect that goes on with this insulin balance is affecting ghrelin and leptin, which has a lot to do with fat burning and eating, but have an even greater amount to do with brain cell health. Okay?
Really?
So now let's go and talk just a moment about this. So these five R's are, number one, is to remove the source. And the source can be, it can be toxic sources like heavy metals, biotoxins, environmental toxins, toxins inside your home. And I talked about this a little bit last week, and we talked about it in the past. When we put cosmetics on our face, women put cosmetics on their face, they're putting over 500 toxins on their face, of which a large percentage of them are actually carcinogenic. We know them to be known carcinogens. Okay, so think about that. Now, what you're doing is when you come in contact with these begin to cause problems with the body, and what we need to do is we need to start to get those that source of the toxicity out of our life, whether it's we remove those chemicals that we're exposed to. You know, I don't know Big Bang Theory?
I do, all the time.
So one of the new episodes,
Bazinga.
One of the new episodes was that Howard was rubbing his mother with this cream. Wasn't using plastic gloves. The cream was an estrogen cream.
Yeah.
And he began to have all these cravings and all these problems.
Emotional things, right.
So, and his wife says, well, if you're using plastic gloves with this, he goes, no, I just put it on. He says, well, this is an estrogen replacement cream.
Sure.
And he goes, then he gets in with Kuthra Polly and they start comparing if his breasts are getting bigger.
Touching each other.
Well, it goes back to, we don't realize the number of chemicals that we come into. Let's look at auto intoxication that occurs just from fillings in our teeth. If they're mercury-based fillings, there's a huge movement these days to these bio dentists that you go to that do a great job. I talked to Athos Kamenis and Nick Vincenzo, my friend down south, and people like that who are dentists, and ask them about this. They're even taking precautions. They're really putting these really good dams in, lots of water to keep it on. They're having to be more and more cautious because they do understand the fact that when we are drilling in those old fillings, that we are vaporizing some of this mercury.
Sure.
And that mercury is getting up into our sinus cavity as a result, and it gets into our lungs and gets into our brain. So mercury poisoning is something that, my brother had a bridge in his mouth, and he was told probably 10 years ago, they said some of the effects of what you're going through maybe from some mercury poisoning, so he had to change his bridge out. This maybe even 15 years ago, because he was having some headaches and things of that nature. So removing the source, getting rid of some of those toxins, and whether we do that through a cleansing program, and let's think about it. If we have these toxins, we can't really cleanse the body. We can't have the body operate as normal systems. The second part of this is to regenerate the inner and outer cell membrane. Now this is where it comes in that making sure that we have the proper lipids in our thing. Like, we want to stay away from trans fats, we want to stay away from sugars, and we want to stay away from the toxins that we just talked about. But in healthy individuals, we have a very supple bilipid layer, and it's sort of complicated to talk about, but just imagine that we have this sort of double bridge that inside of it has fat inside of it.
Mm-hmm.
And it can actually be very malleable and change itself, so it can carry proteins across, it can carry water across, it can do all these different things, okay? And it allows nutrients to flow in and out. Well, when you start to disrupt that, when you start to get it to where these receptor sites are not sensitive to the hormones they should respond to and not able to read, we learned about this model of the cell that said that the cell was, you got this membrane on the outside, and on the inside you get the nucleus, and the nucleus produces all the DNA material, and it's the brain of the cell. Okay,
mm-hmm.
We now know from recent research, from like 1995 to 2005, that's not really the true picture. We now know that we have this whole biosphere around us of bacteria and germs and viruses that are both healthy for us and bad for us,
mm-hmm.
That run the cell for us, that tell the cell, they're sort of like the conductors of the cell. They actually function with their messenger RNA, and it solves a lot of the issues we've thought about of why we do it. Now, why is this important to a fitness program? Because you know what? When you have these toxins, when you have all this stuff going on, you cannot function, and you cannot read yourself, so you can't run your systems, you can't keep your hormones balanced, you can't lose weight Those things are important. So again, we come into getting good sources, and we now hear so much about omega-3, 6s, and 9s, but here's where that supplementation aspect has to come into effect, is because if you take too much of your omega-3s and it's out of balance with the 6s and 9s, guess what? You also disrupt the cell membrane. So it's really important that we make sure our cell membrane can function to get waste materials out, get nutrition in. And the way we do that is keep the inflammation down from that standpoint. So we want to rebuild the inner and outer of the cell membrane. Number three is to restore the cell's energy. And as nutrients feed in and out, what you have working there is called your mitochondria. That produces your ATP and your energy. Now, that's something that is tremendously affected by exercise. So see, when we've been talking the last couple weeks on this show, we've been talking about the brain, the gut, and the immune system all working together. You know, that's part of this hierarchy of how the whole body works. Right. And it's certainly more complicated than what we used to talk about in reps and weight that you do and how many sets you did and whether you did 30 or 40 or 50 minutes of aerobic exercise or if you did body pump or CrossFit or whatever you did. It certainly goes deeper than that from the standpoint of the science of it. And it also comes back and says there is a wonderful balance about how we eat and maintain the health of the system. So this restoring the cell, we want to make sure that we detoxify, we cleanse the body, and this, again, the importance of not having certain stimulants like these neurotoxins, stimulants like saccharin and all those types of things are artificial sweeteners. It also speaks to caffeine. Again, caffeine in moderation is good. You know, caffeine, when you don't drink caffeine, if you have caffeine, what's it do? It becomes an aid to burning and metabolizing fat. Okay? So those aspects of it are very important for us to understand. Why pure, good water? This is why it's such a mission for people like Jim Schultz with his water thing, because he understands that there is a byproduct to the chlorination that goes on in the thing that interferes. And it may be good in little levels, but when it gets to the levels it's having to get to, it's not a good thing. The fourth thing is to reduce inflammation and oxidative stress in the cell. And this comes back to that no-lono cycle that I was talking about. And total inflammation is produced in three main sources: overconsumption of refined sugars and grains, bad fats, and toxins from food sources. Okay? Things like cosmetics, air pollution, toxic cleaning products, and more. Needless to say, inflammation and outside. Now we've talked about the stress cycle. When we have stress at the workplace, when we have stress in situation, when we have pain, when we have family situation, that's also stress that causes this same oxidative stress. And this no-lono cycle is what gets rid of that superoxidase is actually an enzyme that gets rid of oxidase, which is this big supercharged worst free radical we could imagine. But when we have superoxidase, that's the enzyme that's produced one through exercise, two through how we eat in our diet. Okay? The final thing is to reestablish methylation, okay? Mm-hmm. And the body needs these methyl groups to turn off stress hormones is what it needs to do. And this gets depleted when we don't eat right, when we get stressed out, and we don't rest. Now, this is a pretty deep topic, and I would like to bring Dan Papa and at some point to talk about this, because I think it's going to be a great thing to open people's eyes to see this balance, to see the balance of more naturally. It's why we had the relationship with Love's Food, because they brought that component of this very clean eating to our systems. And when we look at and the bottom line is that what we want to do is we want to fix the cell so the body can, you know, the body's a wonderful thing. And so these five R's are really a key to a lot of unexplainable illnesses that people have. Because what do we do? Again, going back to that disease continuum that we have here that we've talked about on this show for the last 2 years. We've talked about this continuum of wellness where we're healthy, and then as we eat the sugars, we smoke, we drink, we have stress, we don't respond, we're inactive, we move down this continuum towards disease. And what's the first step to that disease situation is we go to our doctors and they give us a medication. And that medication is to solve the cholesterol problem or to solve the blood pressure problem or to solve the thyroid problem. And that medication does not change the travel down that disease continuum. And we go back now. What's the synergy of solving this problem? Number one is good nutrition, eating good nutrition. Number two is exercise that takes care of our muscle. Number three is a moderate attention to aerobic exercise, not an overdoing. You know, and it's going to catch up to you when you're doing all this stuff if you're overtraining. Now, that overtraining is only a problem for like 5% of the population, okay? The other 95% of us, 12% of us are exercising on a regular basis, and there's this huge number of 80-some% odd people that they really don't exercise enough. They're not getting meaningful exercise. They think that they're walking through the park for 2 years straight is meaningful exercise when it is not. They need a little bit more. They need that intensity to their exercise, which we're going to talk about in just a minute. We'll get to that part of it. But so I'm seeing so many people that rely and trust to the physicians. And I'm not saying don't trust your physician. I'm saying consult, involve your physician. But understand that one of the things, because the medical practice is so fragmented at this point, what happens is we come in, and it's so fragmented that I go to my cardiologist for this, I go to my gastroenterologist for this, I go to my other doctor for this, and my other doctor for this, and then I have my GP. And rarely do these guys, because they're so busy and they're so overwhelmed, and they're great guys, do they have the time to talk. It's wonderful when I get the opportunity to have a patient, give me a patient release form, and I will call their physicians. And I will talk to their cardiologist, and I will talk to their gastroenterologist, and I will talk to their GP. And, you know, a lot of times I'll say, hey, listen, I'm wondering, can we reduce this medication for cholesterol because I'm a little concerned because it's a statin? And the one physician will go, well, gee, I don't really want him on that statin. Okay, I said, so if you didn't prescribe it, then I have to have him go back and talk to that doctor.
Yeah.
You know, and so communication with your physicians is so important, and letting them know every time you go to the doctor, take that list of medications and what physician prescribed it. So a lot of people are taking medications that they got 5 years ago,
yeah,
and they're not even seeing that physician anymore.
Right. Oh,
and
no.
They don't really remember why they're taking it, but they're still taking it because a very reputable, good person, educated person that cared about their health told them that they wanted them for that period of time.
I saw that with my mom a lot. You know, she took an aspirin a day, and that was great for thinning her blood. And at some point, some doctors said, no, you need warfarin.
Right.
You know, you need a blood thinner. And she really didn't. You know, and then when you get into the blood thinner, you get into the, you have to be checked monthly for your blood. And
your proteins and things like that.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
So.
And I really respect the people who are astute enough to their health. That you know, one of my good friends, Fred Otell, from the day Fred Otell, and actually D.S. Patel, another gentleman I've trained, those guys I respect because you know what? They can show you every piece of paper that I've ever done a test for their physical response on. They have their numbers, and they carry the same good habits forward when it comes to their physician's reports. Mm. I love when a person come in and show me what their cholesterol has tracked that, because they have all those reports in a little notebook.
Mm-hmm.
I admire that. I don't do that. Lord knows I don't do it. And I'm in the industry, you know.
Right.
But I really respect that aspect. And another thing I would say that I would really think is important if you're going to start a fitness program, and it's not for diagnostic purposes, but if you're going to go get in a fitness program, you need to go see your physician. You need to go get your blood work done, because you know why? Not for diagnosis. People like me, that's not our scope of practice to diagnose you. Our scope of practice is to observe and work with things and deal with the challenges we're going to deal with, because especially in dealing with an older population, we're going to deal with the challenges of flare-ups of joints. We're going to deal with that, and we just, everybody has to be patient from that standpoint to work with it and have good protocols, which I think we have really good protocols that work with people on that. But you know, one thing that I've begun to ask my patient or my clients to go as a patient to their doctor, say, listen, ask your doctor, do CRP, C-reactive protein. What C-reactive protein indicator is, it is a measure of your body's inflammation level. It's a systemic inflammation measurement. And when we have that, what is really neat about that is, not for diagnosis, again, I reiterate, not for diagnosis, but for the purpose of seeing how does that correlate to how things change for you. Did that inflammation go down on that number and your blood pressure medication had to be cut back by your physician? Did your cholesterol numbers get better because that inflammation number went down? Those are things that are important to me, because what I want is the outcome. I'm not the diagnostician that the physicians are. I want to be the right arm as a fitness trainer. I want to be the right arm of the medical industry. It's a very natural step. The Alive Across America program has proved that to us. And if you have not seen the Alive Across America program, if you're in New Smyrna or you're in Edgewater or if you're in Flagler and you're listening to the show, you say, "Well, that guy's too far away for me to go to." Go to yourhealthbeginsnow.com. Yourhealthbeginsnow.com. We're in the second week of the Alive Across America. And the first 2 weeks are very preliminary warm-up weeks. But you can get involved in that program for $25 a week. It delivers your exercise directly to your home and the regiment with a one-hour webinar every Monday night. And when you enroll, you'll get the backup webinars, the two webinars that went on before. Right. And you can use this process and go through it. Now, it tells you that no one pill, no one exercise, no one food, no one system, no one piece of equipment is going to solve or reverse your health issues. Okay, so when you know, I'm probably more cautious than ever to get on and say this is the greatest thing in the world, is the only thing that'll work for you doing it like this. I say that we balance. I went to dancing, right? There was obviously a deficit in my program when I began the dance for Dancing with the Stars. What was it? I said, you know what? My core flexibility could be better. Not my core strength. My core strength is great. My core flexibility, because of the wear and tear on my body, needs to be better. So what I do, I went to Pilates, I went to yoga, I went to ballet. All of them serve their purposes. That's why I like to sit down with people. And more people, I'm saying to them, you don't need to exercise 3 days a week. You need 2 days a week. Or if you're really active, you need 1 day a week. And we progress you, but we need to progress, and we'll talk in a minute about intensity. And the importance of intensity, because intensity is what changes the chemistry of the body. And so many of you out there go to exercise every day, and you go in the gym or the fitness center or wherever you're at, and you know what? You do the same weight. You do the same number of reps. You do the same walking routes. You do the same treadmill or cross trainer or whatever. And we keep looking for these magic tools. The tool is intensity. Mm-hmm. That's what changes the body. You know, burst training is a huge tool. You know, I was talking to someone the other day, and they hadn't seen me for a long time. They say, "You know, Tasso, I'm a little taken back about that you're such an advocate of using cardiovascular training." And because he remembers me from the years in the 80s when all I had in my room were the strength training machines, and it was go from one machine to the other, quick, quick, quick. And I said, "Well, here's what I realized, Robert." I said, "Number one is that the average American and the age of the average client that I'm seeing is not capable of working at an intensity level from their start to improve their fitness significantly. And most of these people want quick results. We're used to a quick society, drive through meals, mm-hmm. pick up at the window, that kind of stuff. We're used to quick, boom, results just like that. So I said, in order to accommodate that and facilitate that, we had to find a way. And quite frankly, the burst training allows us to bring intensity into people's program. You know, we have, imagine trying to take a person that has COPD and exercise them on a strength training program where they're going to work 10 or 12 minutes really hard. What's going to happen to them? But ironically, we can train them on only three machines that are large muscle group machines. Mm-hmm. And then take them and let them do 6 second bursts on one of these SciFit machines, and guess what happens? Their spirometry gets better, their fitness level gets better. Now they start to be able to do four machines and do those four machines hard. What we want is, it's not so much how much exercise you do, it's the quality of the exercise. And again, the intensity is what goes down to that chemistry that was very complicated and we talked about in Dr. Pompa's 5 R's, and about how the cell functions, about where the brain and the gut and the immune system all integrate together to create change in the body. And it's the intensity that drives those changes. It's also having the right nutrition that drives that. So I think that we see that there is a value to intensity with that. And that intensity is that philosophy that we've always had of one more rep, one more pound, one more second, one more effort or exertion. Those are the things that I think are real important to people to understand about their programs. So it doesn't matter if you're at Body's Personalized Fitness in Ormond Beach. It doesn't matter if you're at the Y. It doesn't matter if you're at Gold's Gym. It doesn't matter if you're at Planet Fitness. Take that principle, and on that treadmill, try to take that little 10, 20, or 30 second bout where you work a little bit harder than what you did the last time you're on that thing. The other thing is rest. Rest is so important to the body. If we don't allow rest and recuperation and nourishment, how are those cells going to heal? How are those muscles going to heal? How is your body mentally going to be able to stay with a program that allows you to get results, that allows you to come every day and give your best effort? If you go to work thinking about what your workout is going to be that day or how tired you are from getting up early in the morning and you deprive yourself of an hour's worth of sleep, how are you going to function at that level? And to take a step back, I still do believe that about everything I need to do for my fitness level, I can do through my strength training program if I can work intensely enough. You know, I haven't had any problem. You know, one of the big concerns from my Pilates instructor was I going to be able to have good enough cardiovascular fitness to dance this minute and a half routine that I have to dance? I can tell you honestly, Dave, I haven't had any problem with my breathing or my endurance during the course of my dance training I'm doing for Dancing with the Stars. In fact, I hold up pretty well. But in my workouts, I have a lot of trouble breathing because it's an intense segment. It's a 14-minute segment. It's very intense. It's twice a week, but it gets the job done. And then I allow my body to rest afterwards so that I continue to get stronger and better fitness in that. So those aspects of the total programming. And let's remember that, listen, there is no magic pill. There is no one, like we look at these infomercials. And isn't every infomercial is telling you? There's a huge amount of misinformation that goes on out there. You know, they're gonna sell you a drink because the acai berry works. But the acai berry research, you know, all this stuff they quote about the acai berry, right? Do you know what it was actually done on? They never did research on the acai berry. You know what it was done on? Blueberries. But the blueberries are the same family as the acai berry, so they go and they extrapolate that to the acai berry.
As an assumption, yeah.
As an assumption. And you see the acai with the blueberry, right? And a lot of, isn't that how they couple them together?
Yeah.
Okay? Because they want to make you think there is a magic potion. It's a magic component. It's this long-lost nutrient that we lost years and years ago, right?
Sure.
So that's one part of it. The other aspect is that exercise has to move you through the planes of movement. It has to tax you. It has to make you twist and work from that standpoint. So it's very important, and that's why we always are encouraging proper posture to engage those muscles that do that. So when you put things together, that's why if you do aerobics, it's great. But if you do your step or your body pump or your body flow or whatever you do, it's great to complement that with a strength trainer. Listen, when I have people that play golf and tennis, I usually tell them, I said, after the first 6 or 7 weeks, I don't think we need to exercise you more than once a week because they're already active. Once we get them strong enough to let that body heal, and the studies that we see from McMaster's University in Canada brought forward two things that were revelational for me. Number one is that in their research, they showed that people who strength train with a relatively high level of intensity could actually produce progressive positive results if they worked out once every 6 days. That was significant because that said, as we work, we're working hard, we actually need more rest as we get stronger. So when they took the regular exercises, they showed that was once every six, as long as they had other things going on in their life. The second thing that came out of the McMaster studies that I really took away from it was when they did the study and they took 250 bikers, elite bikers now, not just beginning bikers, elite bikers, and they put them on these bikes and they said, look, we're going to time you for 18 miles. Just get your best time for 18 miles. Then they took this 250 bikers and they broke them up into two groups of 125 people each. And what they did with those two groups of 125 people is, okay, you guys train in that normal spinning cycle that you do, 90 revolutions a minute, 120 revolutions a minute. You do 90 minutes a day, 5-6 days a week, okay? They took the other group and they said, look, you guys, you're going to train a half hour a day, 3 times a week. You're going to train 90 minutes a week. What you're going to do is you're going to get on the bike, you're going to warm up for 4 minutes, and then for 30 seconds, you're going to ride as hard as you could possibly ride. And then you're going to slow down for 4 minutes, and you're going to ride at a slower rate. And then for 30 seconds, you're going to go as hard as you can go. And we're going to do 3 to 4 of those 30-second, for lack of a better term, sprints, burst, intervals, okay? Now they go back 14 weeks later, they retest. Both groups, as you would imagine, have improved their times. But the group that did the 90 minutes a week and the group in the burst training or the interval training, they improved by 23% more than the other group did. They did less, but they had more intensity. Okay, so those aspects of it. So, you know, we're able to build programs. That's where we first began to investigate this burst training, because we knew we couldn't take people and put them on for 30 minutes on a bike to ride with a 30-second burst. But we did have a tool that we could put them on 6, 8, 10 seconds of a burst with rest of 2 and 3 minutes between them.
Right.
And that would majorly affect their fitness and their health. So those are aspects of it. You know, before we get done, I know we only got 4 minutes left in the show. I do want to remind people that beginning October 1st, Bodies Personalized Fitness has begun a very special promotion. It is the promotion that is called our Family Fitness Promotion. When you join a regular single membership at Bodies Personalized Fitness, you will receive a family membership. So you, your spouse, significant other, your kids that live with you under your roof, they all have a membership. If you got 5 kids, that's a 7 family membership for about $60 a month. There's no better entertainment. Now, what better membership do you get? You get a membership that allows you to be supervised in your exercise program, have use of our SciFit equipment. Now, hopefully I'm going to be a smart enough businessman to come up with a great special around Christmas time so you can continue to give the gift of health to your family. But this membership, I think, is a very special promotion, because I started thinking as I was doing this dancing, my kids are sort of getting involved and being excited about it, is, you know, there's nothing better than being healthy, being happy, and having your family exercising with you. Those types of things are things that you enjoy. I see the families that come and exercise at the club together. They have great and wonderful relationships. In fact, I'm sitting there going like, man, I need to go to counseling because I don't exercise with my kids enough. You know, I'm too busy exercising everybody else and that type of thing. And I regret that sometimes. I look back on that, Dave, and I go like, man, I should be doing this more with my kids, you know. So those aspects, I think, are important. Family's important, and I want to promote that aspect of it. So from now to the new year, for a single membership, you'll receive a family membership with our Body Coach Supervised Exercise Program. 672-6464 is the number. Okay, you can just give us a call, set up an appointment to come in. We have to have appointments for the first 3 times you work out, because we're teaching you the machines. There is always someone on our floor. Our club is divided up into 3 areas. It's divided up into our Body Express, which is, hey, listen, I just got my own thing. Show me how to use machines and I'll do it.
Mm-hmm.
Body Coach, which is our supervised program, where we're there setting your seat heights and weights and that. And then our one-on-one program. Okay, our one-on-one is the most focused, where I sit down for an hour and a half, go through your medical history, teach you, measure you, give you numbers that are objective so you can compare what you're doing. 672-6464. One last thank you again to Mitch from Love Soul Foods, who was a co-sponsor of the show for about 4 or 5 months. It was a wonderful resource having him here with us. Hopefully he'll be back in 3 or 4 months with us. The other thing I want to do is thank Dr. Fawn for his continued sponsorship of the Fitness Friday show. He comes on the 3rd Friday of every month. He usually brings a testimony in to someone who has benefited from his techniques and treatments. And he continues to help me with staying healthy and staying stress-free.
Taking care of your ligaments and all that.
My ligaments, that's right. Which my ligaments have been rather inflamed as of late.
I bet.
So remember that football tonight on WNDB. Go out and see a local game. Get there, enjoy it. And if you have any questions, feel free to call us here at the station, 239-0033. We'd be happy to take those questions, develop shows and answers for you. And we hope you have a great weekend. We thank you again for listening to Fitness Friday, brought to you by Bodies Personalized Fitness in Ormond Beach, the place where we start you where you're at and get you where you want to be when it comes to your fitness. It's more than just reps and sets. It's about you, your results, your history, and what you want to accomplish. God bless you. Have a great weekend, and thank you very much.
WNDB, Daytona Beach, first in local news. Fox News updates at the top of every hour, online at newsdaytonabeach.com.